Hello everyone, this is Khalifa Muhammad Asif and you are watching EduPharma. Today I am going to discuss about phenol water system, critical solution temperature and its determination. Before going to start, let me first give you a brief introduction about partially miscible liquids. A large number of liquids are known which dissolve in one another only to a limited extent. For example, ether and water. Ether dissolves about 1.2% of water and water also dissolves about 6.5% of ether. Since their mutual solubilities are limited, so they are termed as partially miscible liquids. Here are some examples of such partially miscible liquids. When equal volume of such partially miscible liquids are shaken together, two solution layers are formed. Each layer is saturated solution of other. These two solutions are known as conjugated solutions. So for example, when equal volume of ether and water are shaken together, two layers will be formed. First layer will be saturated solution of ether in water and second one will be saturated solution of water in ether. So these two layers of solutions are known as conjugate solution. By increasing the temperature, mutual solubility or we can say miscibility of such liquids can be increased. Let's talk about phenol water system. When water is added to phenol, it forms two layers or sometimes it may form a turbid solution as they are partially miscible in each other. By increasing the temperature, we can increase their mutual solubility. Let's see the phase diagram of phenol water system. Here you can see the parabolic curve represents one of the two conjugated solutions which depicts the percentage phenol that dissolve in water at various temperatures. The solubility of phenol increases with increase in the temperature. Similarly, we can have the miscibility curve of the water in phenol. Here, the curve represents other conjugated solution layer that gives the percentage of water in phenol. So, the solubility of water in phenol also increases with increase of temperature. The curve in this image represents the miscibility of phenol in phenol and water. Two solutions curve meets at the maxima on temperature composition curve of the system. This point here corresponds the temperature of 66 degrees Celsius and the composition of phenol as 33% weight by weight of phenol. It means above this temperature, any proportion of these liquids will have highest solubility, or you can say above this point of temperature, this system exists in a single homogeneous phase. Thus, at certain maximum temperature, the two conjugate solutions merge, become identical and only one layer results. The temperature at which these two layer conjugate solutions or layers merge into one another and form one layer is called critical solution temperature or upper constituent temperature. Let's see the importance of critical solution temperature or upper constituent temperature. This phenomena, critical solution temperature, is mostly used as criteria to test the purity of substances like phenol.
Now, let's go for determination of critical solution temperature. For that, we require phenol, distilled water. Here I have taken water in 250 ml beaker. I will use it for making water bath. Funnel, measuring cylinder, stirrer, test tube. Here I have taken Nestler cylinder for making this video. Actually, 25 ml test tube is generally used. Other requirement is rubber stopper, thermometer. You can use digital food thermometer of standard grade, hot plate, or you can take simple water bath, and a stand with clamp to hold the test tube. First, maintain the temperature of water bath up to 40 degrees Celsius. Now, for making phenol water system, 4 gram or 3.75 ml of phenol is taken in the test tube. Remember, phenol is acid and corrosive liquid. Great care must be taken while handling it. Now, 2 ml of water has to be added to phenol. You can see here, two layers are formed. If we stir and start heating the solution, first it will form a turbid solution and then form a clear solution as two liquids merge into one layer. In this experiment, the most important task is to observe the transition temperature, that is denoted by capital T. Transition temperature is what? It is the temperature at which these two layers of phenol and water is merged into one layer. Actually, it is difficult to observe at what temperature two layers are merged into one. For this purpose, we can divide the transition temperature in two parts as T1 and T2. Here, T1 is temperature of disappearance of turbidity and T2 is temperature of reappearance of turbidity upon cooling. You can see here, two layers are converted in a turbid solution. Let's continue heating till a clear solution is observed and note this temperature as T1. When we remove test tube from water bath, temperature will decrease. Upon cooling, clear solution will start to convert into turbid solution. This point of temperature at which turbidity starts to reappear, it is noted as T2. By taking the average of T1 and T2, we can get the value of transition temperature. You can see complete solution is become turbid as mutual solubility is decreased. You can repeat the procedure to get accurate readings. Now, for determination of critical solution temperature, we must have composition curve. For that, transition temperature of different compositions of phenol and water has to be calculated. 2 ml distilled water has to be added to get different composition. Similar procedure has to be repeated to get transition temperature. Likewise, 2 ml of water is added every time, and transition temperature of different composition can be calculated by repeating the similar steps. Here I have added up to 14 ml water, and transition temperature of each composition is determined. The observations will be like this. Weight of phenol is 4 gram. Density of water is 0.998, approximately 1 gram per ml, and density of phenol is 1.071 gram per ml. We can calculate percentage weight of phenol as W1 divided by W1 plus W2. Here W1 is weight of phenol and W2 is weight of water. See the observation table. We have to plot the graph of percentage weight by weight phenol versus transition temperature to get the composition curve. From this curve, we will get the value of critical solution temperature. That's it for today. Thanks for watching.